Get excited. Today we're drawing Black Widow in Procreate from start to finish, so don't go anywhere. Let's talk about Black Widow, specifically ScarJo's Black Widow in the MCU. I gotta tell you, I'm a big fan of this character. I wasn't really a big fan of the character before the MCU, which I think tells you something about her portrayal of the character. Similar to that of Iron Man, right? I wasn't a big Iron Man fan before the MCU. I knew of him. I didn't particularly care for him or not care for him. I was completely neutral. Same thing with Black Widow. Did I know about her? Yes. Did I care about her? No. No, not at all. No, I did not. What I want to know is she's been in the MCU for so long. We're talking, I'm pretty sure it was Iron Man 2. I could probably look this up right now, but I'm too lazy to. So we're just going to assume it was somewhere about Iron Man 2. I remember Robert Downey Jr. looking real young. And this is when we saw her. She was a spy. I think she played like Natalie something or other. Hey, it turns out she's Black Widow and she's a badass and she's working for S.H.I.E.L.D. Very cool. Here's Hawkeye. And then yay, Avengers, right? All that to mean that she's been in the MCU for very, very, very long. She's one of the original Avengers. She's such a badass. ScarJo does an incredible job playing her, making her likable, making her affable, really just fitting her in with the whole Avengers gang. My question is, why? Why, after all these years of her being in this universe, would you give her a solo movie, finally, after she's already dead, dude? She's fucking dead. We saw her, you know, jump, sacrifice herself in, you know, one of the more pivotal moments in Endgame. One of those hardcore sacrificial moments which we had a few of in the last couple movies. Why would you say, all right, yeah, let's give her a movie now? He's completely done in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. But now's the time we're going to give her a move. After all this time, after all these years, who do you give a movie to first? Not Black Widow, not a beloved character, but you give it a motherfucking Captain Marvel, dude? Carl Manvers gets a solo film before Black Widow? What world are we living in? What are these studio executives doing? Who thinks like that? What a horrible thought. Oh my God, terrible. Yeah, you know, listen, I spend a lot of time on the internet, obviously, probably too much time. And, you know, listen, I pay attention to what the trolls are doing. I see the videos made and the shitty tweets made about certain characters. You know what? Nary a bad thing to say about Scarlett Johansson's Black Widow. Really, the negative comments about that character are few and far between. And that's the character that you decide not give a solo film. I'm excited for this trailer. I've been excited since that first kind of teaser. I dig the white outfit. I dig David Harbour. He was cool. He was actually good in Hellboy. That movie sucked, by the way. Hellboy was a complete piece of shit, but it wasn't because of David Harbour. He was actually a pretty likable Hellboy. Anyway, I don't particularly care about her other family members. Who cares? One thing that did spark my interest is the appearance of a Mr. Taskmaster himself. For any of you non-comic book dorks, Taskmaster, his ability, he does have a superpower. He's able to, it's like muscle memory. It's like photographic muscle memory. It works like this. Taskmaster fights you. Whatever you throw at Taskmaster, he memorizes, learns, and then instantaneously throws it back at you. So if it's hand-to-hand combat, if you know Kung Fu, guess what? Taskmaster now has Kung Fu, Neo style. But it really is like that. If he's fighting hand-to-hand with Captain America, if he's fighting hand-to-hand with, you know, Bucky Barnes, with Black Panther, Spider-Man, Daredevil, you name it, it makes him one of the most deadly, dangerous villains in the MCU. Also, he's not particularly, like evil to the bone. He's more of a gun for hire. Yeah, he doesn't particularly have, he just wants to get paid. He's being paid to kill somebody. He's out to get his money. Also wondering what this means for Black Widow in relation to the Marvel Cinematic Universe now. Does this undo her sacrifice during Endgame? That was a really, really sad moment. If they just bring her back via, who knows? Listen, it's comic books. For anybody here who knows comic books, you know that nobody ever really stays dead in any comic book universe ever. given enough time, everybody will be brought back, either from the multiverse or alternate universes or alternate timelines or just stealing somebody from the timeline. Nothing ever stays dead. But if you do that, you kind of undo that one moment. Even me, a lunatic, got a little misty-eyed when Black Widow sacrificed herself instead of Hawkeye for the Soul Stone. I wouldn't particularly mind seeing her come back. I think that would be pretty cool. Like I said, I'm a big fan of Scarlett Johansson's and specifically her depiction of the Black Widow. So I'd be down. I'd be down to see her show up again. But for all intents and purposes, that chapter of the Marvel Cinematic Universe is over. Okay, now that I've told you guys why I like Scarlett Johansson's depiction of Black Widow in the MCU, and I've told you that I'm really excited for the newest movie coming out, I'm gonna show you some of the artwork that I'm doing, or the reasoning why I'm doing what I'm doing while I'm drawing. I'm gonna give you an example of the backgrounds that I chose and the backgrounds that I didn't choose, and just general art advice. So if you have any questions, hit me down below, and let's go. Now comes time for everybody's favorite part of the video. I'm gonna break down my art and my process. So this piece is a little bit different. I had intended to not do any real background. What I say by real background is, I was gonna leave it primarily black and white, really kind of like, think of like manga style. Black, white, grayscale, halftone, just a figure, a little bit of foreground, a flat background, just plain black, maybe a little texture, but that's it. And Bob's your uncle. I figured that would be it. Unfortunately, it didn't work. The image ended up looking incomplete. You know, even though I thought the image would work by itself, sometimes you gotta push an image a little bit further so it's a little bit more than just fine. I'm be honest with you guys, I'm lazy. I'm a lazy son of a bitch, and I'll try to get away with doing as little as work as I can in order to make sure that it's good enough. However, it helps to have, and I can't stress this enough, it helps to have people who also do the same thing you do. So when you try to do something like, you know, get away with not drawing a background at all and show them the image, and they say, hey, ass face, there's no background here. What you doing? You have to confront your own laziness and procrastinating, and then you have to, well, then you have to come up with an actual fucking background. Oh God. I tried having no background. I tried having a pure black background. I tried putting that little streak there, and none of it quite seemed to work. I came here, so I thought, let me put a little spider there. Maybe that will do it. Oh, I know. You know, I'll add a splash of color. Let me color her hair and her little belt buckle there. I'll put her little logo on her outfit. And that's it. Are we done? That turns out we're not done. My friends busted my balls. They told me to get back to it and finish telling the story of this piece, which is, well, since she's standing on a mountain of skulls, we're dealing with some post-apocalyptic shit. So my friend says, draw a Quinjet behind her. And I say, draw a Quinjet behind her. So I start drawing a Quinjet behind her, but it didn't work. You see, it fucked with the composition, right? She got kind of lost standing in front of it. It was kind of overwhelming. So I tried shrinking in, that didn't work either. So I said, fuck it, all right, no Quinjet. My other friend, he suggests, dude, do an apocalyptic background. And at that moment I knew, now we're talking. Now we're cooking with gas. Post-apocalyptic background? Hell yes. Now this is my fucking wheelhouse. I got this shit. I could do post-apocalyptic in my sleep with my eyes closed, holding the iPad pen between my butt cheeks. I could do post-apocalyptic easy peasy, and I did. You know why I could do post-apocalyptic so easy? It's because it's just lines. It's like loose lines, dude. You don't even have to like really, like here's some iron grids, maybe. Here's some like crumbling buildings, kinda. When it's post-apocalyptic and like deteriorating is all hell, you can really, really take it easy peasy. I will say what I did when I used the buildings as a background as a backdrop, I did my best to make it so that the buildings weren't overpowering her. I just wanted enough background to help lead your eye to what was happening in the mid and foreground. So I want you guys to look at you, the viewer. Look at her pose, the skulls in front of her, and let the background just guide your eyes. And well, I think I did a pretty decent job at drawing and kind of capturing the essence of a real badass Black Widow. If you have any questions, let me know below. If you have any ideas of who I should be drawing next, please definitely comment. I'm reading all the comments. I'm curious to see who you want next. Let me know. If you'd like to buy some of the art, check out the links down below. You get a print, a t-shirt, etc., etc. Big thank you to my patrons. Also, huge thank you to everybody out there who's been liking, sharing, commenting, subscribing. I'm trying to grow this channel, so I really appreciate every little thing that you guys are doing. It's a big thing to me. So I'll catch you in the next one. And if you want to see me before then, I'm live on Twitch 4 days a week, Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday. So I'll see you there. Bye.